I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Please stay tuned for a moment of silence.
Welcome to this edition of LC Current. Today is Tuesday, January 25th, and it is a gray day. I'm Kate.
And I'm Gracie. Coming up next, your daily announcements.
At last, my love has come along. My lonely days are over. And life is like a song.
Girls tennis has started their official preseason. Conditioning is in the upper gym on Tuesday, Thursday, and Saturday. You must have a physical on file to participate. Contact Coach Taylor if you have any questions. Do you believe in ghosts? Find out if they are real this weekend when the members of the International Thespian Society present Blythe Spirit, our annual winter play. Performances start Friday at 7 p.m. in our auditorium. Tickets are only $6 for students, and you can buy in advance online or at the door.
Attention seniors, the Indianapolis Foundation Scholarship is redesigned to offer scholarships to students of all types, including those who may not qualify for traditional scholarships. If you answer yes to any of these, I want to attend a college or university, I want to attend a vocational, technical, or trade school, I can demonstrate financial need, someone in my family has been impacted by the criminal justice system, and or I will be a first-generation college student, you may qualify for the Indianapolis Foundation Scholarship. All students may apply, preference given to Black students. The deadline is February 1st. See your school counselor or go to www.cicf.org/scholarships. The following scholarships are due. The Tuskegee Airmen Scholarship is due today. The Indianapolis chapter may nominate up to 5 student applicants. In 2021, 60%, 3 out of 5, Indianapolis chapter applicants were awarded national TASF scholarships. The TASF will present 40 individual scholarships ranging from $1,500 to $5,000. If your GPA is at least a 3.0, please consider applying. Please contact your guidance counselor for assistance.
Upcoming college visits, Regent University will be here tomorrow at 9:30 a.m. and Avita Fredericks Institute Indianapolis will be here on Friday at 9:30 a.m. In the mood for some hot chocolate before school, the LC players will be selling hot chocolate before school this week in the cafeteria. $1 a cup and 25 cents for toppings, including marshmallows and whipped cream. Stop by before you go to your class.
As you may have seen, the armed forces are visiting lunch blocks regularly. Each branch of the military has been assigned one day of each month to set up in the lunch area. Please feel free to stop by and ask questions. If you are planning to join a branch of the military, there may be a need to meet your recruiter during school hours. This is only permitted during a study hall block. Please make your recruiter aware of your class schedule. You and the recruiter need to notify parents, counselor, and grade level administrators. This can be as easy as an email to all concerned parties. If you have any questions, please contact Mr. Taylor or Mr. Gilbert in the guidance office. Key Club and National Honor Society are having a clothing and food drive on Friday and Saturday. Check out the Canvas page announcement for more information.
On Thursday, LC will be hosting Academic Planning Night for parents. Topics will include diploma types, graduation pathways and requirements, and scheduling procedures. If you are a sophomore or junior, the meeting will start at 6 p.m. If you're a freshman, it will start at 7:15 p.m. The meeting will be in the LC cafeteria and you need to enter door 16. Attention seniors, applications for the LTSS scholarships are now being accepted. The deadline for submission is February 7th. Contact Nancy Liss at nancyliss@msdlt.k12.in.us or at 317-423-8300 for more information.
Engledow Group is a premier landscape and design organization that has become well-diversified and respected over the last 90 years. We value relationships, our employees, high moral and ethnic mindset, and quality work first and foremost. If you are energetic and motivated, love working outdoors and or with horticulture, you get along with others in a very team-driven environment, have a valid driver's license, able to do physically demanding work, and finally, you must have a great attitude and be willing to learn. Then, this can be a tremendous opportunity for you. Application link, www.engledow.com/careers for a full listing and to apply. Or email Tammy at tbaker@engledow.com. Set construction for the thespian play will continue tonight. Join the Remind for further updates and times. Our final committee meeting before the show will be tomorrow at 4 p.m. in the auditorium.
Today's vocabulary word is control, a noun meaning a personality or spirit believed to actuate the utterances or performances of a spiritualistic medium.
Did you know Etta James was born on this date in 1938? She was born James Etta Hawkins in Los Angeles and had a very tumultuous childhood, as she was brought up by foster parents who ill-treated her. By the age of 5, she was known as a gospel prodigy, gaining fame by singing in her church choir and on the radio. At 12, she moved north to San Francisco, formed a trio, and was soon working for bandleader Johnny Otis. 4 years later, she recorded Roll With Me, Henry with the Otis Band. After signing with Chicago's Chess Records, her career began to soar. She continued to work with Chess throughout the 1960s and 70s. Sadly, heroin addiction affected both her personal and professional life. With suggestive stage antics and a sassy attitude, she continued to perform and record well into the 1990s. She possessed the vocal range of a contro alto and was initially marketed as an R&B and doo-wop singer, but broke through as a traditional pop-styled singer, covering jazz and pop music standards. Always soulful, her extraordinary voice was showcased to great effect in singles such as At Last, Dance With Me Henry, and I'd Rather Go Blind. As she entered her 70s, Etta James began struggling with health issues and eventually succumbed to leukemia. She died in 2012 at the age of 73.
Celebrity birthdays: Ariana DeBose is 31.
Michael Trevino is 37.
Alicia Keys is 41.
And Jennifer Lewis is 65.
This has been Today's Current.
Thank you for joining us.
Stay positive and test negative, LC.
Please stay tuned for this additional announcement.
Edith, would you be a dear and clear the cups?
Is there anyone there? One rap for yes, two raps for no.